Remember why I said, so the basic reasoning for that answer is for this question, okay? We just discuss it very briefly, okay? For credit spreads, I'll just place this once again. And I added this new condition of the corporate leverage ratios will remain the same, okay? Why did I add that? Because if you increase without any change in economic prospects, understand what happens to credit risk of a corporate if you increase the leverage ratio? It will increase because it becomes a riskier company. Okay, beyond a point, of course, there is a beyond the point, that is just the theory, what the theory says. But in general, we should go with the assumption that if you increase leverage ratios, the company is becoming more and more risky. Okay, because the chances of equity holders getting paid are less, and even the debt holders getting paid is reducing. Okay, so you have to work on this logic. I will paste this logic once again. Make sure you read this properly. And so your answering on these points was not proper. Anyway, so let's go back to what we were covering, which is, we can, okay, we'll have to show you the CP marks, okay? You can see it later, it's not a big deal, okay? No, no, you see it later, I'm not gonna waste class time. One minute. You have access to these spreadsheets, okay? Nobody's gonna open them, just a matter of 15 minutes. Nobody's gonna open them now, okay? I'll make sure that the totaling is correct, and then you'll get your marks, okay? So don't worry about all this. We'll go back to your, this is the full data on Apple. Let's go back to this part, what we were discussing, okay? We looked at Can you see GABA at the back?
Yes.
You're able to see? Okay, so we looked at option payoffs. Remember in the last class, before we got interrupted, we were looking at option payoffs. We looked at the long call payoff, okay? We looked at the short, we were just starting on the short call payoff, all right? Before we got interrupted. Okay, but now let me just briefly tell you something about the long call payoff, okay? You look at this long call payoff. Everyone is able to understand the long call payoff. We already discussed it in the class, okay? This is the short call payoff, okay? So remember, these are called hockey stick diagrams. So you can, as a rule of thumb, you can understand if you see that the intercept, this kind of this constant part is above the zero line, that means it's a short position in options, because this part represents the premium inflow. Okay, and when this goes below the zero line, that means it's a short option, it's a long option position because it is a premium outflow. Okay, and then so this, by looking at this immediately, you can figure out that this is a short option position. Now all you have to figure out is whether it's a short call or a short put. And what you see is that as the underlying, remember this is the underlying expiration, these are expiration diagrams. Remember these are expiration diagrams. These are profit diagrams, not payoff diagrams, because you're incorporating the impact of the premium, okay? And they are, these are called hockey stick diagrams, okay? So if somebody asks you what are hockey stick diagrams, this is what they're referring to, okay? Now, in this case, it's a short call because, as you can see here, as the underlying price closes higher and higher above the strike price, the strike is 100, you are losing more and more money. Is that clear? You're losing more and more money as the underlying closes further and further away, higher than the under strike price. So what position, what short position behaves like this? Short call or short put?
Short call.
Short call will behave like this, because if you're short call and the market price keeps on rising above, higher and higher above the strike price, then that position is, you're losing money and you're short the position. So your P&L is going down, okay? So you have to study these diagrams properly, okay? Make sure you're very familiar with these diagrams. Basic diagrams will clear up your basic concepts. Now, one thing we want to study here, we want to learn why we used a particular type of terminology. Now, if you look at this framework here, which covers everything, we have everything here. Now, do you notice something here that it says that options have what kind of payoffs? Linear or non-linear? In this diagram, options are said to have non-linear payoffs, okay? Payoff and in this case, although we were discussing profit diagrams, payoff will also look the same way, okay? Because the premium is a constant. The premium is plotted as a constant, so it doesn't change, because it is paid up front at the beginning, okay? Paid or received up front at the beginning. So the profit diagrams, if it's nonlinear, the payoff will also be nonlinear, okay? Or the payoff is nonlinear, the profit diagram will also be nonlinear, okay? So remember that I've shown you that all the other types of instruments are linear, whereas options are non-linear instruments. Sometimes they're just called non-linear instruments, okay? Sometimes also called symmetric versus asymmetric, okay? I don't know if I mentioned that here. I'll put in this note here. So the distinction, first understand this is the concept that you're learning, a new concept, okay? That we make a distinction between options and all other types of instruments. We say that options have non-linear payoffs, okay? Or non-linear profit profiles, okay? And all the other types of instruments, are you following this logic here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I mean, why we'll come to later, but at least what I'm designating, how I'm classifying them, that is clear from the diagram.
Yes.
Okay, so we are classifying all this futures, forwards, cash, spots, swaps, all are classified as linear instruments, okay? And others, options are called non-linear payoffs, okay? Sometimes they're just called non-linear instruments, okay? And so the other term that is also used is symmetric versus asymmetric. So what I will do is, maybe this is control shift, no, this is not. Control alt M, is it? It's not in the right slot. So I'll put this in later. So this linear, you have to remember, linear is also called symmetric, and non-linear is also called asymmetric, okay? That should be logical. So we use these two types of terms to distinction. Now, why do we say that, okay? Why do we say options have non-linear payoffs? It's because of this kink in the profit profile, okay? Because of this kink, it's not linear. There is a kink in this diagram. That's why we call it non-linear. Is this clear? If you look at the payoff diagrams, it'll also have the same kink, all right? That's the only reason, okay? And if you briefly look at, now why do we call things like futures, spot, okay, cash, spot, futures, swaps, why do we call them linear payoffs, okay? Because if you look at a long futures position, I don't know if you can see the numbers here, you can't see the numbers, but maybe we'll just increase it a little bit. Now, Gawa, you can read this 40.
Yes, sir.
You can read the 40 here. So if I'm long futures at 40, understand this, okay? Understand the basic difference between linear and non-linear. Why do we use these expressions? So futures we take as one example. Cash, spot, everything will be the same. Okay, so what are you plotting? Y-axis is profit or loss. X-axis is what happens to the futures price, okay? So if you are long futures at 40 and the futures price has risen to, you went long at 40, okay? And the futures price has risen to 50. So are you making money or losing money?
You're making money.
Okay, this is a long futures P&L. Okay, so in this case, obviously you are making $10. So this should be around here, $10. Is this clear? All right, so this is how this plot is derived. Why does it look like this? Because this is what you do. Now, if you're long futures at 40 and the futures price drops to 30, then are you making money or losing money?
Losing money?
You're losing money. How much are you losing? You will lose $10. So this must be minus 10 on the y-axis. Is you clear? Himani, are you following? Okay, 30 is the price. You're long at 40. So the P&L, which is plotted on the y-axis, y-axis value should be minus 10. Okay, so this is what. Now, if you do the same thing for short futures, it will just look like this way. It will just cross this line like this. Is everyone clear? Okay. So this is why these are called linear instruments for short. Actually, what they mean is instruments with linear payoffs.
Yes.
Okay. The proper expression would be instruments with linear payoffs, but for short, people just say linear instruments. And this is why options are called non-linear instruments, because of this kind of kink in the payoff profile. Is this clear? This is the first thing that you have understood. Okay. Now, payoffs versus linear versus non-linear instruments. Now you have some further idea about the elements of this framework, okay? Why we use this term, okay? All right, so now short call, all right? Then understand this, long put. First, straight away, premium is $7. Immediately you can see that this part, the constant part, is below the zero line, okay? That means you must, this must represent the payoff for a long position. Because the premium is shown as a negative, that means you have to pay money to put on this position. That means you must have bought the option. That's why your premium is an outflow. Alright? So that you know straight away. So this is, must be a long position. Now the question is this a long put position or a long call position? How would you know?
Put.
Long put. Why is it a long put?
Because we are selling.
Yes? Baba?
Profit when the prices are falling.
Yeah, it's making profit because it's increasing the profit when prices are falling. When the underlying price is falling, we are plotting the underlying price, then the profit keeps increasing. Okay? So therefore this must be a long put, it can't be a long call. Okay, because long call, nothing would happen. As in fact, the long call would lose more and more value. Intrinsic value would keep going down, okay, up to zero. All right, long put. So now this is
short put.
Straight away you can, these are mental shortcuts that I'm giving you. If you see that this thing, the constant part is above the zero line, this must be a short option position because the premium is shown as a inflow. Therefore, it must be a short option position. Now, only things that remains to be determined is whether it's a short call or a short put. In this case, it's a
short call.
Short call. Be clear as to why it's a short put.
What?
Yes? What is your answer?
Explain the logic behind short put.
Short put, why? Because
prices are falling.
I mean, the underlying price is falling, and your, what is happening to your P&L? Is getting worse or is it getting better?
Worse.
It's getting worse. You're losing more and more money. So, which kind of short position will lose money as the underlying price drops? Short call or short put?
Short put.
Short put. Okay. Because the holder of the long put is making money, so you as a seller will have to be losing money. So this is how you figure it out. Remember, always remember the logic. Don't memorize stuff. Okay? Don't memorize stuff. Remember when we did the underlying position testing in corporate treasury risk management?
Yes.
How do you figure out the underlying position?
Yes.
You ask whether the entity is making money when the oil price rises.
Yes.
If they're making money, then the position must be long. Because they're making money when the price rises. Remember? So this is how you should remember to do this. Logically. Everything should be logical. Now look at payoffs. No restlessness. I have set an alarm. There's no need to get restless. Look at the payoffs. Make sure you understand now the difference between payoffs and this is the correct definition.
Sir, this type of options do not make a premium.
You are forgetting the difference. How did I distinguish between payoffs and premiums? I mean payoffs and profit. How did I distinguish between payoff profiles and profit profiles? Profit is intended to include loss. So the correct expression would be payoff profiles versus P&L profiles.
Okay.
Payoff profiles versus P&L profiles. And what is the difference between the two, Sena? You understand why Sahil is confused? Because he is not seeing the premium part being reflected here.
It's a premium hitting here, sir.
Don't confuse. I want to know from Sina. What was the difference between payoffs and payoff profiles and profit and loss profiles? Anybody?
Sir.
No, not you. Anybody else? How is it that nobody else has understood this point? It has already been explained in the class.
Premium.
1 minute. Yes. Who is answering? Baba. Yeah. Yes.
The difference of premium.
What is the difference of premium? So what is the difference between, let's say I'm asking you a question, what is the difference between payoff profiles and profit and loss profiles in option trading, in option analysis? Yes? What is the answer to my question?
So the return.
Why is everybody confused, Pallavi? What is the answer? Not clear? How is it? This is such a basic thing. Okay, now one sec. Yes? Now we are not going to waste more time on this. You better go and revise this very basic stuff which has already been discussed, which people still don't know. Payoff profiles do not incorporate the impact of premium. That's why here payoffs are not showing the impact of premium, plus or minus. Okay, that's why here this is the payoff for what kind of position?
Long call.
Long call.
Long call.
But it does not show the payoff. So long call, you can see here, it straight away it starts rising from K is the strike price. As soon as the market, underlying market rises above the strike price, the long call position starts showing a profit. Because we are not showing, it starts showing, strictly speaking, a positive payoff. Because in the payoff profiles, we do not incorporate the impact of premium. Okay? Is this clear?
Yes.
This is what kind of payoff profile?
Short call.
This, 1 minute, be quiet. 1 minute. What is this kind of, what profile is this? Long put. And what is this?
Long
call. This is short put, right? Okay, now let's see, let's examine Mr. Tanu Jindal's assessment. Okay, yeah, there seems to be a problem with the alarm. It's not functioning well. Okay guys, you can go.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome, welcome. So Sina has to send me an email about the last class's negative marks. So you can have a look at your CP marks. I think everyone has gone above zero.